Yep.
Do you really dig this stuff?
I'm up to bet my Ferrari against your engine.
Ferrari?
Yep.
Brand new Ferrari against my 2-year-old MG.
It's a good car. I know how you dig it.
All right, I'll buy. What do I have to do?
Just spend the night. Make sure there are no ghosts.
Look, Jake.
I'm dead serious. Dad carried the loan on the place in the bank. When it came due, he turned it over to me. Now, I can't sell it or can't even rent it with all this ghost stuff.
So, you spend the night, and I'll let you decide if the place is haunted. Now, let me get this straight. All I have to do is spend the night, and if there are no ghosts, your beautiful new Ferrari is mine?
If there are no ghosts. $5 on Hank. Sounds like you don't believe in ghosts. $10, no, backed up dick. $20 on Hank. $20? Now, we'll just leave it dead for Friday.
Do I have to do it alone? I mean, can I invite a few friends?
No, why not? That's even better. They'll be able to back you.
No trick.
I never thought of that. No trick. Word of honor.
All right. What not?
Well, I'll leave it up to you. Tell you what. You name the date, and I'll come by and help you get started. But come dark, I'm gone.
Good enough. What do you think about that? Well?
I think you're crazy, both of you.
Would you spend the night in Hanley's house?
Why not?
Why wouldn't you trust it in the place?
Beautiful new Ferrari.
Your MG that's soon to be mine.
Jim, my MG ready?
We'll be this afternoon.
Good.
Are we going to win our bet?
Yeah, sure. See you at the party.
I'm not coming.
Why not?
Hanley House? No, not me.
You too, huh?
They've been calling me a witch again.
No. I don't want to go alone, and I can't get anyone to go with me. I thought maybe you might tell me something about the place, and...
You foolish young people, I don't know anything about the place. All I know is what talk there is, and the fact that about 3 years ago, Tom and Annabelle Hanley just up and left without a word to anybody.
After that, all that ghost talk started up again. Let's see, there's old Higgy. She spent a night out there, and she's been nuttier than a fruitcake ever since. Only two people made it through the night, though many have tried. They usually leave after the first funny goings-on.
Two people spent the night. Who was the other?
Old Charlie Benton. He acted awfully funny afterwards. And a few months later, they found him hanging from a rope in his garage. He'd done himself in.
Yes, I remember. Mother wrote me about it.
Whatever happened to Higgy and old Charlie, no one ever knew. They wouldn't talk about it.
Higgy just rolls her eyes and babbles when you ask her. The others had different stories. Some heard babies crying, others felt cold hands and saw lighted candles moving about. They all had different experiences. Well, that's about all I can tell you, except to be careful.
Where did the...
the bedroom, and all the lights are out except in the hallway.
Okay, I'll take care of
it. Goodbye, Barrister Gaskin.
Hey, is Isabel spending the night?
No, sir. Night is home. I won't be nowhere near this house.
You superstitious, Isabel?
No, I'm not superstitious, but I'm not crazy like a lot of people I know either. There's been a lot of funny things going on around this house. And I'm not sitting around to see if it's one ghost or if it's ten. Come night, Isabel will be happily sitting in her bed sleeping. Like most decent people I know.
Hey, Morgan, I forgot to ask. Do you believe in ghosts?
Not since I was a kid.
I know you do. Or you're just trying to sell your house.
Well, Sheila does.
Now that's three for and three against. We can't even get them to charge you.
Well, count me out. I'm with Isabel.
You are afraid, aren't you?
Look, the best for you to spend the night.
We don't want any tricks, now do we?
Look. Someone's moved the painting. This way, the lawn.
You're right.
Need any help?
Yes, those drapes need hanging.
You think anyone else will show up?
I doubt it.
He said he might come. He was still busy at the shop.
You know, I think we should have an agreement. Morgan, you and Sheila along for the fun. Gabby's here for research, and I'm here to win a bet.
Don't do that.
Oh, sorry.
Now, I know Dick could keep his word that there'd be no tricks. But then just about everybody in town knows we're here. And somebody might decide to have a little fun with us.
Did it ever occur to you that someone might want people to think this place is haunted? That someone might benefit by it?
Yes, but I didn't have time to check on it.
Well, I can't imagine why.
I do think, though, that whatever happens, we should find out what it is and where it comes from.
That's Pete.
Sheila, would you get it, please?
Showing up in the daytime.
Somebody is having some fun. It is cold here.
No.
What is it, Gabby?
It's the imprint of a spirit. Or someone is being very clever. I think we've had a visitor from the other world. It's a troubled spirit. May even be seeking revenge.
Here you are, the first little sign, and you get all shook up.
Dinner served. Psychical power. I realized it when you first came to see me while coming here. That's why I came.
You better join the others.
Yes.
Thank you.
Have you been here long?
Only a few months. They tell me you grew up around here.
Yes. Nice little town. Nice people. Getting nicer all the time.
Oh, dear. Oh, Hank. It's your deal.
Right. Get something lively. This is the last time. The name of the game is Hank Ware. You shuffle?
Yeah.
Above your head, a black widow spider.
Get something and kill it.
Well, where is it?
It's gone.
But it couldn't have just vanished.
Morgan, there's a flashlight in the glove compartment in my car. Get it.
Right.
You want to check?
No.
Morgan, stop it. Your hands are like ice. Stop it, Morgan. You're choking me. You're choking me.
To choke me. Its hands were ice cold. They tried...
It's all right. Relax. Now, who tried to choke you?
It did. It did.
You didn't see who it was.
It wasn't anyone. Just a pair of ice cold hands. And the clock. It began to tick. And the painting here.
What is it? What happened?
It's Sheila. Someone tried to choke her. Look.
Who wound it?
No one.
Well? This is where she wants to hang. This is where she'll stay.
It's not a tree.
Did you see anything outside?
No, nothing. It's quiet and peaceful as a cemetery.
That box. Where did it come from?
You better not.
Looks like an ordinary box to me.
But where did it come from?
Your junk is just a box.
With a seal all around. Great, it doesn't belong to us. Maybe something that Hanley left here.
I think we'd better call it a night. Our imagination seems to be working overtime.
Someone inside the house.
If it is someone, he's just trying to scare us. I don't think we're in any real danger.
Unless it's a madman.
Sheila. You're imagining things again. Go to bed. Tomorrow we'll laugh about all this.
Hey. You all right?
I'm just a little nervous.
See you in the morning.
Put that box downstairs. I know it wasn't there before. I didn't notice it myself before the hallway incident. Gabby, you don't think there might be someone inside the house?
Listen, Sheila. The spirits are trying to communicate with us. I believe they picked you as the contact.
But why me? Why not you?
We don't question them. You're the one they've chosen, and you must cooperate. Don't fight them. If you help, we may find out what this is all about.
Sheila, come, Sheila. Thank you.
I want to go home.
Let's go down and stay in the library and try to stay the night. We'll stay together. Gabby?
Yes.
Dick?
What?
Yes. Sheila? Let's get dressed.
Feeling better?
Yes.
What do you make of all this, Betty?
We most definitely have had a visitor from the other world. All we have to do is wait for it to reveal itself and make its wishes known.
I feel we're on the verge of a genuine breakthrough. Now's the time to make contact. Oh, I've never felt more like having a seance than I do at this moment. I'm glad you decided to stay.
Well, I admit it's getting to me.
Patience.
I want to contact the spirit. I'll need everyone's help. Come, we'll sit at the table.
We're going to have a seance?
Yes.
May I just sit here and watch?
If you wish. Now, once the seance is started, no matter what happens, you must do nothing, absolutely nothing, to break the spell. You all understand it?
Concentrate.
Remember, Sheila, don't fight it. Now, I want your complete attention. We'll all hold hands. Relax. Close your eyes.
Relax. Concentrate.
Relax. Concentrate. We're here at Hanley House. We want to find out what's happening here. Now you can open your eyes. Concentrate. I'll contact my guide. Is there anyone there who wishes to speak with anyone here? Zizi, are you there? Zizi, is there anyone there with a message for anyone here? Oh, Nenta, go away. I don't want you. I want to talk with Zizi. Nenta's a lonely spirit. Very naughty, in fact.
Netta, was that you misbehaving here this evening?
Are you sure?
She says she's never been here.
Well, was it anyone else?
I mean, anyone I know.
She says,
only evil spirits come here.
Evil spirits?
Yes. They were evil in life, so they're evil in death.
No, Linda, you can't stay. If you'll go away, I'll have a seance just for you. Yes, very soon.
That's a good girl.
Yes, it was nice. She's gone. I have to do that. Oh, Zizi. Zizi, can you tell me? Zizi? Zizi! She dashed away. Seemed frightened. I've never known a spirit to be frightened before. Is there anyone there who wishes to speak with anyone here? Is there anyone there who wishes to speak with anyone here? Is there anyone there who wishes to speak with anyone here? Is there anyone there who wishes to speak with anyone here? Is there anyone there who wishes to speak with anyone here?
Where's the flashlight?
On the card table.
It's not here.
What do you mean it's not there? I put it there.
Let's go.
You go. I'm staying.
Come on, Gabby. You can research another time. Dick, your car keys.
Battery's dead.
So's mine.
What now?
We walk. Come on, we'll take a shortcut.
Thank you.
This way.
We're going around in circles.
Yeah. Come on. Let's go back to the fork. Take the other path. This way. Thank you.
We'll go inside.
No.
We can't break the spell now.
No. I'm not going back in there.
We have no choice. We have no choice.
We'll try to communicate.
How?
Oh. It knocks again. In the name of the Lord, what do you want?
I made contact, but it doesn't want me. Perhaps it's Sheila.
No.
Don't be afraid. I'll tell you what to say. Repeat what I said.
In the name of the Lord, what do you want? Now stop that! You behave yourself. It was someone else. Dick.
No, I don't want to.
You see, we do make contact, but Dick won't...
Wait. In the name of the Lord, what do you want? Henry McIntyre.
What are you doing here?
We came because of you. Can you tell us what you want? body, all right. No. Where? It's me they want.
You?
I couldn't help it. I had to.
You had to?
I couldn't take it any longer. They wouldn't let me go. All these years, they wouldn't let go. It all began when we were boys together. They were putting up a new schoolhouse. One day, Tom Hanley and I and another boy was playing there. The boy got down into the wall of boards. There was a large tram of fresh cement nearby. The tram tripped and spilled into the vault. The boy was buried alive. There was nothing we could do. We just stood there, helpless. Tom said it was my fault that I tripped the tram. And nobody would believe it was an accident. Because everybody knew I disliked that boy. He said not to worry about it. That he'd never tell. That he'd protect me. But he did want my new baseball. That was the beginning. All these years he's bled me. My business, my inheritance, must be close to $100,000. One day I came by to have it out with him. I had enough. The door was open, so I came on through to the kitchen. I could hear them down here. Tom's laugh stopped me on the stairway. And then I saw it. He and Annabelle sat there with a bag full of money, counting it, laughing about how their own private little bank paid out such good dividends. Then he began to brag about how he found out I was going to leave town, that I wouldn't get away. See, he'd already sold off his livestock. It was time for them to move on, too. Annabelle giggled and said, Tom Hanley, you're just too smart for Sam Morgan. And he laughed long and loud. And he told her just how smart. How it was he who took the tram and killed that boy. Well, I guess I must have gone mad.
The next thing I knew, I had the axe he'd left on the stairs in my hand.
Thank you.
No, he'll find his way home. We've work to do.
I had to. I had to. I couldn't help it. I had to.
Where we should look for the other part.
Perhaps if something happened.
Once here, there, the pain. The fireplace. Just threw in Hanley's body. And the care he took with Mrs. Hanley.
I think it's odd his coming here tonight.
Perhaps the criminal returning to the scene of the crime.
He must have been mad.
I wonder where he hid the money.
Well, we'll probably never know.
Coffee's ready.
Can we have it in here? Now we need lumber, another hammer, a couple of saws. Take measure from the tool shed. If we hurry, we can make it.
If Morgan's battery wasn't there, we could use his truck.
I have a feeling it'll work now.
You don't think we ought to notify the police?
No. There's four of us to tell what's happened. Afterwards, they can check all they want. For now, we do as we were told.
His neck's broken.